Hello everyone, you already know me, I'm Nikhil from iGeeks blog, and today in this video, we are going to talk about each and every multitasking tips for iPad that includes split screen, slide over, center app and lot more. So watch this video till the end just because I don't want you to miss any tips and tricks. This video is sponsored by Shazzle Chat. It is the world's first application that allows users to have their own peer-to-peer private network without a man in the middle. This means no web, no server, and no centralized record of the communication contents are ever created. And our data is 100% safe between us. Use Shazzle Chat to invite your trusted contacts, create groups, chat securely, share media and files, and add a passcode to always keep your chat secure. And the great thing is, it's completely free. Visit the link from the description or search Shazzle Chat on the App Store to download it now. But before I start sharing everything with you, let me ask you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and turn on all the notifications so you never miss such great content from us. Now, if you have done that, let's first find out which iPad are supporting multitasking. iPad 5th generation and later, iPad mini 4th and later, all models of iPad Pro, iPad Air 2 and later, running iPadOS 15 will support all the features of multitasking. After knowing the list of supported iPads, it's time to understand the different finger gestures, which is the most important, or I must say, most needed in multitasking. On home screen, swipe up with one finger to top and it will open apps feature. And you can switch between apps quickly. With the same gesture, you can also open apps feature from any application. Another way to open apps feature with the help of 4 or 5 fingers. Pinch into the screen, hold it for a second and it will open the apps feature. And to force quit the application, simply swipe up the app card. Now let's learn the 3 different ways to switch between the apps. First, we already have seen with the apps feature. Another like iPhone, swipe left or right from the home indicator at the bottom of the screen to switch between the apps. And use 4 finger to swipe left or right to switch between the apps. Now, it's time to talk about the multitasking on iPad. In iPadOS 15, when you open an app, it shows a 3-dot menu named as a multitasking button at the top middle of the screen. We have 3 options, one for a full screen, another to split screen, and the last one is to slide over that app. By default, applications on iPad open in a full screen. And to split it up, simply tap on the split screen option. Now select the another app that you want to use in another split window. We can also change the app in a split view screen, open dock on the iPad, and drag the app on the split screen to change. You can also select the app from the app library and view it on the split screen. Or simply hold the multitasking menu and swipe down. It will move another app and will allow picking up an app from the iPad's home screen. Now let me show you how the spotlight helps you to bring another app to split view. Instead of picking an app from the home screen or a dock, simply swipe down on the home screen and from the spotlight search, pick the app from a Siri suggestion or search for an app. We can also resize the split screen window. Simply tap and hold the divider and move left or right to resize the split screen like this. With 2 different ways, we can change the sides of the app in the split screen. One is from multitasking menu. Select it and select a split screen option and select the side to move the screen. Another with the help of gesture. Drag and drop the app to another side and it will change the side of that app in the split screen. This is the very simple way to create a split screen with the help of multitasking menu. But there is a hidden way, and that is with the app switcher. Open app switcher and from here, drag and drop an app to another app and it will prompt to create a split screen window. Create one or more and simply access all the split screen from the app switcher. And to simply close the split screen, tap on the multitasking menu and select the full screen option. Another way is to drag the divider from all the way to left or right of the screen to close the split screen. After split screen, it's time to talk about the most interactive and attractive multitasking feature on iPad, and that is slide over. The very first way to create a slide over of the app is from the multitasking menu. Select the third option and that application is shifted as a slide over app. Now select the main full screen app when the current app slides towards the edge and the initial app will float over the second app. Tap and hold on the multitasking menu on the slide over and drag it on the screen to reposition the window to the left or to the right. We can easily hide the slide over window. Hold the edges of the window, now slightly push towards to the screen edges and it hides the window. And to bring it back, swipe inside from the screen edges. We can use more than one app in the slide over. From the dock, drag and drop the next app you want on the floating window. And to switch between apps, swipe left or right on the horizontal line at the bottom to access the next app. Or swipe up and hold and it will open the app switcher. And we can simply pick the app to switch in the slide over or swipe the card to remove the app from the slide over. After getting idea of split screen and slide over, it's time to learn how to switch from a slide over to split screen or split screen to slide over and vice versa. To switch to the split screen, tap on the multitasking menu and select the split screen option. Now pick an option to keep that window left or right side of the screen. Another way is to drag and drop the slide over the window and to the left or right side of the screen to switch to the split screen. In the same way, you can also switch to full screen. Select the full screen option from the multitasking menu or drag and drop the window to the top middle of the screen to switch to the full screen. Now switch from split screen to slide over. Select the slide over option from the multitasking menu or simply drag and drop the app and it will create a slide over. Now we can also have a slide over while using a split view. In split view, open dock and drag and drop the app in the divider of the split view. And you can access that application as a slide over along with the split view. Now let's come to the point and talk about the most interesting and attractive. I guess I already said that, right? But I want to share something that is really helpful in multitasking and that is app switcher. We have already seen how to force close from app switcher and also how to create split screen with the help of app switcher. More things that are advanced like we can switch the app position in the app switcher. Just like changing the position, we can also close the split screen right from here. Simply move out apps from the split view and it will close the split view. And if you wish to kill that app, then swipe up on the app card and it will kill that app from the app switcher. Slide over apps are also visible in the app switcher. Simply swipe left on the screen to reveal them all. And you can switch between them from here or kill the app. Right from app switcher, you can also move an app from slide over to split screen. And also split screen to slide over apps. In app switcher, we'll show a double window icon next to the app name for which multi windows are open. Tap on that icon and it will show all the app windows. Right from here, you can also add a new window. Just tap on the plus icon and it's done. You can also view all the app windows right from the dock. Tap and hold the app icon and select show all windows. You can close app windows by simply swiping it up. And also reopen closed windows from the same screen. Along with all these great features, iPadOS also brings some great feature and that is shelf window. Let me show you how it works. If you are using Safari in the split screen and along with that, you have also opened a window of Safari in a full screen. Now whenever you open Safari from the dock or from the home screen, it will prompt the shelf to pick a window. The center window works with messages, notes, and mail app. I have already opened multiple windows on my mail app and one center window of new mail. In apps feature, we cannot see a center window, but we can access it by simply selecting a multitasking option on the mail app and it will show all the open windows from the app. Or in a mail app, simply tap on the window icon at the bottom of the screen to view all the open windows of the mail application. We can also add this center window to the full screen, split screen, or as a slide over from the multitasking menu. But I usually like a center window to create new email. I hope you guys are taking a note of each and every feature that I'm sharing right now. If you are not, then let me share one great feature that Apple introduced with iPadOS 15 and macOS Monterey, and that is Quick Note. There are three different ways to access Quick Notes. One, by swiping from the bottom right corner to the center of the screen and it will create a Quick Note. If you are using an iPad with a keyboard or a Magic Keyboard, then press Globe key plus Q to access a Quick Note. And another way, from the Control Center, from Settings, Control Center, and over here, add a Quick Note to it. With a Quick Note, we can make system-wide notes to quickly note some pointers for our reference. It works with all the application, but I personally like using it with the Safari. At a time I access the Quick Notes, it shows me an option to add that open link to the Quick Note. Also, when we select some text from any web page or from a PDF or other, it will show an option to add it to the Quick Note. And with that, I can paste copy text, handwrite something with the help of Apple Pencil, and few more. Apple offered us an option to create more than one Quick Note. Simply press on the New Note icon to create a new note. Swipe left or right to view all open Quick Notes. And we can view all our Quick Notes from the Notes app. A separate folder of Quick Notes has been created and all our Quick Notes are saved here. Now let's talk about the very last feature of multitasking that I'm using a lot, and I guess you are also using a lot while watching my video and playing it in a picture-in-picture mode. If you're not, then let me show you how you can play it. To enable picture-in-picture mode, navigate to Settings, General, Picture in Picture, and toggle on the switch next to Start PIP automatically. After that, you can play within the PIP mode for supported apps like Apple Music, Apple TV Plus, and more. So with this last tip and all other great tips, we have reached to the end of this video. I'm sure you are using some other multitasking tips. Do let me know in the comment section down below. And with that, like this video, share this video, and subscribe to my iGeeks blog channel and turn on all the notifications so you guys never miss such great content from us. One more thing, download our all new iGeeks blog app to enjoy exclusive content about everything Apple. Now allow me to say goodbye, that I really don't want to, but I'll see you guys in my next video. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay connected.